Hi, I'm Samir. Let's extend our learnings on finding the product of two numbers a bit further. Let us begin by taking 2007 and 213 as an example. Here, our working base would be 2 into 1000 and 2 into 100, and our differences would be 7 and 13 respectively. Note, here our multiplier is 2. We can now proceed to write down our answer, which would be 3 parts. Let us begin by writing the third part first, which would be simple product of 7 and 13 giving us 91. To find out the second part, we'll have to take the larger number and choose as many digits from right as is the difference in the number of zeros in our secondary bases, which in our case is 3 minus 2, 1. So we will split 2007 as 207. 7 will come in the second part and 200 would go in the first part along with the difference obtained from the second number, which is 13, giving us 200 plus 13, 213. Now, since our multiplier was 2, we'll have to make a minor adjustment by multiplying 213 into 2, giving us 426, and the second part would be 14. Now, since the number of digits which could be accommodated in second part was only 1, so 1 of the 14 will have to be carried to the first part, giving us 426 plus 1, 427. Now we can club these parts and get our final answer as 427491. Please note that the third part will always have the number of digits equal to the number of zeros in the base of the smaller number. Let us now take 1993 into 197 as an example. Here again, our working bases would be 2 into 1000 and 2 into 100 respectively, and our differences would be minus 7 and minus 3. Please note the multiplier again would be 2. Now we can proceed to write down our answer, which would be in 3 parts. Let us begin by third part, which would be the product of the differences, minus 3 into minus 7, giving us plus 21. To obtain the second part, we'll have to choose the larger number and choose as many digits from right as is the difference of the number of zeros in our working base, which in our case is 3 minus 2, 1. So 1993 will be split as 199 and 3. 3 will come to the second part and 199 will go to the first part along with the difference obtained from the second number, which is minus 3, making the first part as 199 minus 3, 196. Since our multiplier was 2, we'll now have to make a minor adjustment. We will multiply the 196 with 2, giving us 392. We'll have to do the same with the second part, which is 2 into 3, 6. Now, we can club these and get our final answer. Also note that the third part will have as many digits as is the number of zeros in our base of the smaller number. So we can now get our final answer as 392621. Let us try to multiply 2996 into 317. Here, our working bases would be 3 into 1000 and 3 into 100 respectively, and the differences would be minus 4 and plus 17. Now we can proceed to write down our answer, which would be in 3 parts. Let us begin by writing the third part first, which would be minus 4 into 17, minus 68. To obtain the second part, we'll have to take the larger number and choose as many digits from right as is the difference in the number of zeros in our working base, which in our case would be 3 minus 2, 1. So we'll split 2996 as 299 and 6. 6 will come to the second part and 299 will go to the first part along with the difference obtained from the second number, which was plus 17, making the first part as 316. Since our multiplier is 3, we'll have to make a couple of adjustments. We'll multiply 316 with 3, giving us 948, and the second part 6 will also have to be multiplied by 3, giving us 18. Now, before we can write down the final answer, we'll make some changes. The second part can have only one digit, so the extra one will have to be carried over to the first part, making it 948 plus 1, 949. And the third part cannot be left negative as per second rule, so it will borrow 1 from the second part, which will now become 8 minus 1, 7, and our final part would become 100 minus 68, giving us 32. Now we can join these parts and write our final answer as 949732. This is it for now. Lots of new stuff coming your way. Stay tuned.